to the beautiful Rath Eastlink Community Center in Truro, Nova Scotia. My name is Michael Petter. This is Petter Sports and Streaming through Atlantic Hockey Online, a division of AO Live. And this evening we have for you from the Rath Eastlink Community Center the home opener for the 2023-24 season for the U16AAA Fundy Thunder in the Nova Scotia U16AAA Hockey League. Now that's a bit of a misnomer for the league, as it does include teams from all three maritime provinces, but the league started out as a Nova Scotia-based league, and so that still is the name of the league. And it is the home opener, as mentioned, for the Fundy Thunder, who of course draw their players from Pictou, Colchester, and Cumberland counties, although the majority do come from Pictou and Colchester counties. They are taking on the Cabot Highlanders for their home opener tonight. Now, I should start off by saying that I apologize for some of the stuff I put on social media where I had them as playing against the Basin Armada. That was entirely my fault. I had the wrong opponent for the Thunder for their home opener, so I do apologize for that. It is indeed the Fundy Thunder taking on the Cabot Highlanders to kick off this Nova Scotia Under-16 AAA Hockey League season. For the Highlanders, it isn't kicking off their season, however. They've already played a couple of games. For the Thunder, it is indeed not only their home opener, but their regular season opener as well. Before we go any further in this pregame show, we must take a moment to acknowledge on this day, which is the eve of the National Day of Truth and Reconciliation, that the Rath Eastlink Community Center, the entire town of Truro, the entire community of Colchester County, and for that matter, the entire region covered by the Nova Scotia Under-16 AAA Hockey League, which, as mentioned, does include all of Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, and Prince Edward Island, all lies within the ancestral and unceded territory of Mi'kma'ki. And as a member of the Settler Society, I am quite proud to say that I am, when I'm not doing this, I am a teacher at a Mi'kmaq community school in Pictou Landing, and very proud of my role in the reconciliation of the Settler Society with the Mi'kmaq people. Let's get a little bit more into the preparations for this game, and let's start by taking a look at how the Highlanders have done so far this season. As mentioned, they have played a couple of regular season games already. They are 0-2 to this point in the year. A hard-fought, tough 2-1 loss against the Rebels, and that was last Sunday at home at the Port Hawkesbury Civic Center. They also lost their home opener the day before against the Dukes, and that was a 6-0 loss in that one to the Dukes. Both of those games played at the Rath Eastlink, or at the Port Hawkesbury Civic Center. And for the Highlanders, they draw their players out of Antigonish, Guysborough, Inverness, and Victoria counties, I do believe. It's the Quad Counties area there on either side of the Canso Strait. So for the Highlanders, they are still looking for their first win of the season. They have just the one goal in the two games played, while they've given up 8 over those two games. Now, to be fair, that is only 2 games played, so it's not a big sample size. It's not a big indicator of how the entire year is going to go. If the losing streak to start the season extends a little bit further, obviously then that starts to become a concern. But at this point, it's only 2 games. They have the ability to bounce back. And looking at the roster for the Highlanders, there's a lot of names that I recognize here from the U15AA championships that were hosted in Antigonish last year. And so this is a team that has talent. This is a team that has some depth. And this is a team that will find their way into the win column their share of games this season. For the Thunder, as we mentioned, this is our first look at them in the regular season. They've played some preseason games with a couple of preseason games that were played. They defeated the Kings by a score of 3-2, and they defeated these Highlanders by a score of 7-1. They also had another game against the Highlanders that they won by a score of 3-0. So they had a very strong preseason. The fact that they did get a couple of wins against this Highlanders team back early in September does certainly bode well for the Thunder, although it is no guarantee of regular season success. But it is certainly a positive for the team that does play some of their games out of here at the Rath Eastlink Community Center. On the league schedule right now, it still does show some of their games as to be played out of the Colchester Legion Stadium, or at least as of, let's see if I can find those games. And see. Actually, no, they have changed them on the league website now to the Pictou County Wellness Center. So they'll be splitting their time between the Rath Eastlink Community Center here in Truro and the Pictou County Wellness Center just on the outskirts of New Glasgow and Stellarton in Pictou County, much like they did last year. Of course, prior to Hurricane Fiona, the Colchester Legion Stadium was their primary home facility, but the damage as a result of Hurricane Fiona has made that building still not able to be used this season. So for the Thunder, this building and the Pictou County Wellness Center will be their home for this season, as will Petter Sports and Streaming. We are quite proud to say that we will be providing streaming service for all of the Fundy Thunder home games this year, and we are very proud to do so. We started our relationship with the Fundy Thunder late last season. We were able to pick up a few of their final few regular season games. We missed, I think, the last couple of games because there were some conflicts, that, and those games ended up having to be rescheduled a couple of times. And when they got rescheduled, they ended up coming into a conflict with some tournaments that we had to do. As of right now, for the regular season at least, and for the playoffs as well, we will be your home for Highlanders hockey here on Petter Sports and Streaming, part of Atlantic Hockey Online through AO Live. Let's take a look at tonight's keys to the game. And the number one key to tonight's game is, and I say this with tongue somewhat implanted into the cheek, there are going to be Happy Meals aplenty tonight because we got McDonald's all over the place. Four players with the surname McDonald in this game. Not only that, two of them have the same first name. You've got Aiden McDonald and Aiden McDonald on the Highlanders. Yes, that's right. Two Aiden McDonalds. Both of them are forwards. If they end up on the same line, that's it. I quit. I kid, of course. And then for the Thunder, you've got Carson McDonald and Ryan McDonald. And for the Thunder, those two, Carson McDonald was with the Wearwell Bombers of the U15 Major League last season, if I remember correctly, and is going to be a big part of this team this year. The two Aiden McDonalds, I have to admit, I'm not as familiar with them. I've seen one of the Aiden McDonalds play a couple of times, but whether that's the Aiden McDonald who's wearing number 11 or wearing number 17, I honestly can't say for sure. But those are four of the players who are going to be in tonight's game. So there's McDonald's everywhere. Now, the second key to tonight's game, I'm having a little bit of fun with the fact that the team name is Highlanders, and I'm making a reference to the movie from 1986 of that same name, or 85, excuse me, 1985 of that same name. And one of the songs off of the soundtrack, and the soundtrack was the Queen album A Kind of Magic, one of the songs off of that soundtrack was called Gimme the Prize. And so I'm making that key number two, Gimme the Prize, and I'm referring to which team is going to have more success winning battles along the boards, winning that prize, getting that puck out of those battles off the boards. The team that wins more battles along the boards, in my mind, is going to go a long way towards having success in this game. And the third key to tonight's game is going to be the two men who are going to be standing about 200 feet apart for much of the game this evening. That is Jake Thorne of the Thunder and Tucker Broussard of the Highlanders. That is your goaltending matchup. And which one of those two guys has a better night certainly could go a long way in determining which team comes away with the victory tonight. So there you have it, your keys once again. Happy meals aplenty, give me the prize, and tonight's two starting goaltenders. As we await the teams making their way out onto the ice, we mentioned this is the home opener for the Highlanders, and the Nova Scotia Under 16 AAA League home team wears dark, so when the Highlanders come out, they are in their dark blue jerseys with the white trim. The Cabot Highlanders are in their white jerseys with the blue trim with a little bit of green in there as well. The blue along the sleeves, the green on the numbers, blue numbers with the green piping. And Tucker Broussard leading his team out onto the ice as he will get the start in this game. As we mentioned, Josh Gillis, the captain, also out there as part of the starting five. And let's send things downstairs for some pregame introductions.
Number six,
So there you have all of the pregame introductions. All that's left now is to get the puck dropped on the 2023-24 regular season for the Fundy Thunder and for the Cabot Highlanders, their first road game of this 23-24 Nova Scotia Under-16 AAA Hockey League season. Looking at the league schedule overall, this is the only game on the schedule tonight, so no out-of-town scoreboard to keep you up to date on. It's, if you're a fan of this league, this is it for the night, and we do thank you for being here with us wherever you are tuning in from. And speaking of that, we'd love to know where you're joining us from. And you can reach us one of three ways. You can get to us through X, what used to be called Twitter. You can get to us through Facebook, or you can reach us through mjahlnetwork.proboards.com, and we'll give you more details on all of that as the first period goes on. But right now, we are underway here at the Rath Eastlink Community Center. Thunder with the puck in their own zone, played up the boards. It goes off the skate of King, and down the ice is going to roll right in onto Tucker Broussard. He settles it there for his defenseman, Brett Connors. Connors able to make a quick pass, and now the Thunder will, or the Highlanders, excuse me, will come out with the puck. There's the captain, Connors, making a couple of nice moves. The captain, Gillis, making a couple of nice moves, getting in, and Jake Thorne covering up, hanging on for the first faceoff of the game, just 33 seconds in for the first stoppage in play as Jake Thorne covers up the puck. Thorne, as we mentioned last year with the Wherewell Bombers in the Nova Scotia Under-15 Major Hockey League, had a very good year with the Bombers, a team that did have their struggles. There's a chance as the puck came off the end boards, and Owen Wood overskating it just a little bit, couldn't get his stick on it quite as clean as he would have hoped. Would have had a very good scoring chance there on Tucker Broussard. We mentioned Thorne last year with the Wherewell Bombers in front of a team that had their struggles last season, still came out with a decent 6-12-0 record, a 4.01 goals against average, which when you consider the struggles that the team had, that number actually was pretty good. And now here are the Highlanders as out they come, pass ahead to Bowie. Bowie coming in. Bowie with a shot, he scores! Aiden Bowie able to find some space behind the defense, receives the pass, and a minute and 7 seconds into the first period, Aiden Bowie opens the scoring. It's 1-0. And for Bowie, that is his first goal of the regular season. First point as well. We mentioned in the opening that the Highlanders only had one goal in their first two games, so not a lot of players coming into this game with points. In fact, Josh Gillis scored the goal. Austin Landry and Jaden Cameron had assists. As we get the announcement of Bowie's goal, Alexander Broussard and Zachary Oliver with the assists on that goal. So again, it's Aiden Bowie from Alexander Broussard and Zachary Oliver at 1:07 to open the scoring here this evening. As we, there we go, get the scoreboard updated for you there, which gives me an opportunity to remind you that if there is a discrepancy between what we all know the score to actually be and the score that you see on your screen, take what you know to be the truth as the truth and just realize that I haven't hit the right button yet. Aiden McDonald, number 11 Aiden McDonald, working his way down the ice with the puck. Now King will come out of the corner. He'll send it in behind the net. Thorne settles it there for his defenseman, Ryan McDonald. In on him, forechecking hard is McPhee. McPhee tries to get it to the front of the net for King. That'll be steered away, and now William Singer coming out. Singer dumps it right in onto Tucker Broussard, and Broussard hangs on for a faceoff. 2:28 gone here in the first period. For some of these players coming up from U15, this is a bit of a new level for these players, and with the new level comes a new time frame in their games as well. Some of these players, this will be the first year playing three 20-minute periods. And the adjustment of a 60-minute hockey game versus a 50-minute hockey game, not a big one, but certainly is part of the growing experience. Here's Singer dumping the puck in, but did not quite gain the red line, and so that's going to be an icing call against the Thunder. And another possibly new experience for some of these players. At the U15 level, depending on where within the U15 level you played, icing, you could still change lines. But at the U16 AAA level, there is no line change coming with an icing. Connors with a shot. That's blocked by Ryan McDonald. He'll get to the puck, ring it around the boards. Held in at the line there by Rovers. He works it down the wall, trying to get it to his captain, Gillis. It comes back to Rovers again. Now Webb takes a hit from Ryan McDonald, gets the puck to the front of the net, and it'll roll to Vandenberg. Vandenberg moves it forward onto the stick of Dawson McCauley. There's a shot from Kavanaugh, as Kavanaugh took it from McCauley. Thorne making the save and hanging on for a faceoff. 3:20 gone here in the first period. And looking at this Thunder lineup, it's quite interesting. There's a good chunk, a heavy chunk of this team is from Pictou County, a good chunk of them from the Pictou County U15 AA team that had a lot of success last season. A few players from the Wherewell Bombers of the Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League who play out of Pictou County. And a good share of Colchester County players as well, and I believe one or two from Cumberland. As the Thunder get the puck down the ice, now trying to put some pressure on. Puck is played around the boards to Alexander Broussard. He sets it up for Oliver, who's able to get it out to center. Dumped back in again. Coming after it on the near wall is Cole McNeil. He got it as far as Bowie, and then Bowie took a hit, and it's back down into the corner, picked up there by McClellan. McClellan gets it to the side of the net. That'll be cleared away from danger by Oliver. Oliver gets it into the corner. Bowie coming in after it. He ends up colliding with Mathis George. George ended up spinning and falling, and the puck ends up behind the net with Cole McNeil. McNeil plays it ahead. Now pass out to center. Picking it up off the near wall is Bowie. Bowie working his way in. Bowie looking to get it across, but a nice play there by Gage Stewart to get his leg in the way of that one. Stewart, one of the, if I remember correctly, few returnees on this Fundy Thunder team. A lot of players from last year's Fundy Thunder lineup with the week's majors this year. Waylon Countway battling in the corner there against Rossi McPhee. Now the puck will come away with Gage Stewart, and Stewart will get it ahead. That pass ends up going behind his intended target of Carson McDonald, and that's going to be another icing call against the Thunder here as we are just shy of 5 minutes gone in the first period. We mentioned that you can reach us through what we used to call Twitter. My handle is @Petter, P-E-T-T-E-R, as in my last name, Michael Petter, PC_sports. That's @PETTER, PC_sports. Go to Facebook.com and search for the page Petter Sports and Streaming, and the and is an ampersand. Or you can go to mjahlnetwork.proboards.com. And look for the section that is marked All Other Levels of Hockey. And then under All Other Levels of Hockey, you'll see a game day thread. Or you'll see a post, NSU16AAA GDT, which stands for Game Day Thread. It's listed as Armada at Thunder. That was posted when I still had the wrong opponent for the Thunder for this home opener. But that is the game day thread for this game. It does have the right date on it, at least. As we get a little bit of pushing after the whistle, Austin Landry taking some offense to a Thunder player a little bit too close to the crease. And nothing will come of that with 5:37 gone in the first period. If you're just tuning in and you see the 1-0 on the scoreboard, the goal coming just a minute and 7 seconds in, a beautiful lead pass to Aiden Bowie. was able to allow him to come in all alone on goaltender Jake Thorne and put it past him for the opening goal of the game. Bowie able to get in behind the Thunder defense and take the nice pass. Gillis delivers a hit on Paris as Paris dumps the puck back into the zone after it had come out. Now here's Jaden Cameron with the puck. He gets it out to center. Paris dumps it right back in again. Back to get it will be Brett Connors. Connors loses it as the forecheck was there. That was Jackson Harrison creating the turnover, but Harrison's pass to the front of the net couldn't connect with anybody. Now Harrison gets the puck again, tries to set it up for O'Neill, but that ends up missing him, goes into the far corner. O'Neill will come out of the corner with it. O'Neill fans on a shot attempt as getting his stick in the way there was Andre Rovers, and now the Highlanders will pick up, and out they come. Here comes the captain, Gillis. Gillis gets it over to Cameron. Cameron shot through the traffic, save made. Gillis gets the puck, takes it below the goal line. Now it's out in front. Webb gets a shot, but Thorne able to keep the door closed and cover up for another faceoff. 6:40 gone here, opening period. The Highlanders right now seem to be very, very strong with a quick strike attack. They get possession of the puck and they move it up the ice in a hurry, and have been able to create a breakaway, have been able to create a couple of odd man rushes. And it's something that the Thunder are going to have to be cognizant of. Here's Cole McNeil with a shot, and Thorne able to glove that one down easily and hang on for a faceoff. A little bit more about Jake Thorne. Not the biggest goalie in the net. Comes in at around, I'd say, 5'4", 5'5", somewhere in that ballpark. But has really good crease movement. That's one of the things I've been impressed with him over the few years. There's a shot from Cole McNeil, and it goes off the outside of the post. Thorne may have gotten a piece of it as well to change its direction just enough. Puck comes back to McNeil again. He works it down the wall to Broussard. Broussard gets it across to Kavanaugh. Kavanaugh steps in. There's a shot. Thorne steers that aside. Kavanaugh chases the puck down in the corner. Plays it to the front of the net, but only blue shirts there. And now Singer will carry it out. Here's William Singer. Singer with a shot. And Tucker Broussard makes the save and hangs on for a faceoff. 7:20 gone here in the first period. So we've got two Broussards on the Highlanders, Tucker and Alexander. You've got two McNeils, Nolan and Cole. You've got the two Aiden McDonalds. And I think those are the only surnames in common. Puck comes around the boards to Kavanaugh. He plays it ahead, not able to get it up to Bowie. Now McClellan will get it down into the near side corner. Bowie has it taken away from him. Here's Daly. He gets it out to McClellan, and McClellan with the shot, and Tucker Broussard makes the glove save and hangs on for another faceoff. 7:45 gone here in the first period. We'll have the faceoff stay inside the Cabot Highlander zone. Somebody from the Thunder came into the faceoff circle a little too early, so we'll have Wood taken out of the faceoff circle. Coming in to take the draw now will be Henry Dugan. Dugan wins the draw to the near side board. Stepping up from the point is Countway to get onto that puck. But it's taken away by Nolan McNeil. He'll get taken into the boards. And Carson McDonald now ties up with Rossi McPhee. Coming out of the corner with the puck is Wood. He'll play it, take it up the wall, and then play it across to the far side for Stewart. Stewart's shot is redirected and ends up coming off the end boards. Gets covered up by Tucker Broussard. And we'll get another stoppage. 8:12 gone here in the first period. 1-0 off the goal by Aiden Bowie, his first of the year. And as mentioned, if you want to get in touch with us, you can get in touch with us about anything. Let us know where you're watching from, who you're cheering for. If I get a player's name wrong, send me the correction on the pronunciation. If I do say a player's name incorrectly, I should point out I'm never doing it in an attempt to poke fun or ill will or any sort of offense. It's a genuine, honest error if I do get anybody's name wrong. Here's Nolan McNeil. He'll play it off the wall and down the ice. And icing is indicated and will be called with 11:18 left to go here in the first period. And again, you can reach us through Facebook, through X. I still have a hard time calling it X. I mean, we all know what it is. It's Twitter. It is Twitter. It's just a new name, and I suppose that's their business, and they want to change the name of it. They can, but as the puck rolls in onto Thorne, and then Landry had lost his footing and slid into Thorne, which, of course, that draws a reaction from the Thunder defense, but there was no intent there by Landry. And so cooler heads quickly do prevail, and everybody skates off to their own corners, and all is well in the world. Gillis comes in to take the draw against Damon O'Neill. And now O'Neill will get thrown out of the faceoff circle because Hayden Dwyron came in just a little bit too early, so Ryan McDonald will come and take the draw instead. Thunder get possession off the faceoff, and here's Jackson Harrison cutting to the outside up the right wing. Harrison stops, puts the puck into his feet, then finds it and tries to set it up for O'Neill, but that pass just misses the target. Now the puck will come back to the line, held in there by Vandenberg. He fires it around the wall. It'll come up the near side boards for Dwyron. He takes a bump there from Connors, ends up getting taken down. Gillis will get the puck to the line and out as he works there against Harrison. Now pass across to the far side, a little bit out of the reach of Webb. Webb did get a piece of it, and then he and Ryan McDonald go into the end boards heavily. Gillis ends up with the puck at the line. He'll play it down low. Comes around behind the net. Vandenberg picks up there. He's got Webb all over him. Coming in to help out is Ryan McDonald. He'll pass it ahead, and coming up with it is Singer. William Singer dumps the puck in. A few Thunder players were making changes, so the puck is able to be worked back out to center ice. Vandenberg dumps it in again. Now another of those long lead passes, and Webb did get a piece of that puck, so it was not an icing. Now it's played around, and Singer will pick it up for the Thunder. Take it back behind his own net. Come out the near side. Pass across to Vandenberg. Vandenberg takes a look. Now his pass connects with McCauley. Dawson McCauley brings it in. McCauley was member of the leadership group last year for that Werewell Bombers team. If I remember correctly, he was one of the assistant captains. Now with the puck, Oliver plays it around to the far corner, but the first one to it will be Weatherby for the Thunder. He plays it back around to the near side. Cameron will get it there. He'll tie it up along the wall. And as the puck comes loose, Aiden McDonald, number 17, is able to get it. And we're going to get our first penalty of the game. Interference is the indication. And it looks like it's going to be Cole McNeil who goes off. So the first power play of the night becomes the first power play of the regular season for the Fundy Thunder, as the Highlanders will be shorthanded off of the interference penalty taken by Cole McNeil. Let's see. The penalty kill of the Cabot Highlanders at this point, 75%. And I'm going to guess with two games having been played, that's they've killed off three of four, or they've killed off six of eight. I can't imagine that they've had to kill off. There's a chance, and what a save there by Broussard off of a beautiful deflection by Ethan Daly. I can't imagine that they've been shorthanded 12 times already and have killed off nine of 12. I think six of eight, more likely three of four through two games, as there don't tend to be a lot of penalties in the Nova Scotia Under 16 AAA Hockey League. Here's McClellan with the puck. He gets it down to Daly. Daly's redirection goes wide, gets it back, tries to play it to the front of the net. That gets knocked down. Now here's a shot from the wall by Cantway, and the puck does get in. The initial save was made by Tucker Broussard, but he couldn't keep a hold of the puck, and it looks like it's going to be Ethan Daly getting the goal. And that will be Daly's first goal in the Nova Scotia Under 16 AAA Hockey League, as the rookie picks up the power play goal at 8:16 or at 11:44 of the first period, and they get that puck taken over to the bench for a souvenir. Ethan Daly with his first ties up this game at a goal apiece. as we get confirmation of the goal. They announced Jacob McClellan as the assist. I thought for sure Waylon Countway would get an assist on that as he took the initial shot. And if anyone from the league office is watching this game, and I know in some leagues they do go back and take a look at some of the video and whatnot, I can tell you with pretty much certainty that Waylon Conway fired the shot from the wall that was saved and then the puck dropped down. So I would say that Waylon Countway should have gotten an assist on that one. Now, of course, I'm just a play-by-play guy watching the game from up here above. So I, you know, have different sight lines than the officials down on the ice do. And I'm not trying to be critical of the officials. I'm just trying to say that what I saw and what it looks like as Cameron dumps the puck right in onto Thorne. It ends up going to Webb. Webb now, his pass intended for Cameron, but ends up going just a little bit behind him. Cameron had space in front of the net if that pass had been on target. Now behind the net, Gillis. Webb was also right there. Puck is played out to the far side. Dugan will pick it up. He'll get it out to center. And it's quickly picked up by Oliver and dumped right back into the Thunder zone as we play tied here with about 7 minutes and change left to go in this first period. Gillis with the puck, plays it back to Cameron. Cameron's shot is deflected high into the air and it will go up into the netting behind the net of Jake Thorne. And so we'll get another stoppage with 7:04 remaining here in period number one. Thunder's next home game will be next Friday, and it'll be from right here at the Rath Eastlink Community Center. And of course, we will have it for you here on Petter Sports and streaming through AO Live. As we mentioned, we are very proud to be able to bring you all of the Fundy Thunder's home games this season. It might not always be me, as there's a hard hit delivered on Vandenberg. I might have one of my colleagues, such as Alex Terrio, cover me a game or two here or there. There's a chance in front for Dwyron. And the save made by Tucker Broussard as all of a sudden, Hayden Dwyron had a puck right there for him. And it looked like he was almost surprised that that puck came to him. And delivered a quick shot, and Tucker Broussard able to make the glove save and hang on. 10-10 the shots on goal, 1-1 the score. Here with 6:41 left to go in the first period. Puck played back to Countway at the line. He'll send it around into the far corner for Singer. Singer taking a look. Now he'll come out above the goal line. Couldn't get a shot away as he gets taken back down low and taken into the boards by Austin Landry. Thunder win the battle on the boards, though. There's a shot from the line by Countway. That's knocked down before it gets all the way to the net. Landry not able to clear the zone. Now it is sent out by Alexander Broussard, but it's picked up quickly by Stewart and brought right back in again. He gave it to Singer. Singer had it knocked away from him by Broussard. Played around to the far side. Landry not able to get possession. And now with it, that was George. George couldn't get, or sorry, that was Countway rather. And now coming the other way, here comes Bowie. Bowie coming in again. And a big leg save made there by Jake Thorne. Looked like Thorne overextended himself, got going too far one way, but was able to get that leg back and make the save as nearly a second goal of the game for Aiden Bowie. Puck comes to Aiden McDonald, number 11. Waylon Countway now will bring it up for the Thunder. Takes it down towards the corner, takes a bit of a bump, but is able to get the puck over to McCauley. McCauley gets separated from it, and now the Highlanders are able to work the puck to the line. Not quite out yet. Now it comes out as McPhee will send it down into the Fundy zone. Back to get it is Troy Hunt. Hunt able to get it out. It's picked up by Nolan McNeil, and the assistant captain and defenseman will carry it in. Fire a shot. That goes just a bit high. McPhee gets it off the end boards, gets a shot away, and the save made, and the net ends up getting knocked loose with the significant crowd of humanity off to the side of the net. They end up knocking the net loose, and so we'll get a stoppage with 4:51 left to go here in the first period. We should mention as well that while you are watching these games, if you want to go back and check out a replay, you are able to do so yourself. Unfortunately, we don't quite have the gear with us yet to set up replays and all of that. And we don't quite have the manpower either. I've got one guy operating a camera, and I've got me doing play-by-play. So we don't have anybody in the booth setting up replays and all of that for you quite yet. Maybe someday we'll get there, but if you want to go back and watch a replay of any play, you are able to go back and forth throughout the broadcast, throughout the course of the game, and of course all games will also be posted to YouTube. Give us a little bit of time to get the games processed and put up online, but they will all be up online. As long as there's no issues with YouTube itself, which sometimes there are if the music gets too loud or something and they think we're trying to monetize off of the music, which we never are, then sometimes there's a bit of an issue there, but we're usually pretty good about getting games up. If not that evening, certainly well within the next day. Puck is played off the glass by Vandenberg. It takes a bit of an odd hop and ends up finally with Wood. Wood trying to get to the outside against Connors. Takes the puck all the way down into the corner. Connors is able to steal it from him there. Wood steals it back. Now it comes towards the front of the net. Turning and firing is Dugan, and it ends up going just wide. Now another shot. That one off the stick of Ryan McDonald. That misses the net. Just holding it onside is Vandenberg, but he puts it right onto the stick of Connors, and Connors able to clear it out down the length of the ice. Back to get it is Vandenberg. Takes it behind his own net, then reverses the field as he plays it to Ryan McDonald. McDonald gives back to Vandenberg. Vandenberg can't get the puck past Cameron. It's fired around the boards to the far side. Cole McNeil will get to it before it leaves the zone, but ends up putting it right where Henry Dugan can pick up, and Dugan will get it down into the Cabot Highlanders zone with under 3 minutes left to go here, first period. Battle in the corner. In there is Carson McDonald. Coming out with the puck is Dugan. Dugan puts it off the side of the net. Now Carson McDonald back on it again. Has it poked away from him. Cameron and Dugan battling there. Now it comes all the way back up to the top of the zone. Stewart coming across the blue line. Across the top of the line. Fired a shot. That went wide. Now it's poked out to center as O'Neill couldn't get the puck back in deep. Damon O'Neill gets it back right in front of his own bench. Takes a bit of a bump and the puck ends up with Carson McDonald, but we're going to get a penalty here. Boarding is the indication. And it looks like it is Damon O'Neill who's going to go off for boarding. So after the Thunder scored on their first power play of the game, we'll now have the first power play of the evening for the Cabot Highlanders. And so this will be the first penalty kill of the season for the Fundy Thunder. And the Cabot Highlanders so far have yet to score a power play goal. One thing we don't have access to is specifics on how many chances they've had so far. The only thing I can see is that they are at 0% for power play so far this season, which puts them in a tie for fifth. Only four teams have scored power play goals so far this year. But again, we're still very early in the season. So take these numbers with a boulder of salt, not just a grain. There's a shot and a glove save made by Thorne. And for Thorne, that is his 14th save on 15 shots so far here tonight. And there's 1:24 left to go in the penalty. That, again, was a boarding call taken by Damon O'Neill. 1:35 left to go in the first period. So the differential, 11 seconds. We'll be back at 5-on-5 for 11 seconds at the end of this first period. Nolan McNeil had to chase the puck down in neutral ice, couldn't get a handle on it. Jacob McClellan will send it deep into the Cabot zone. And now the Highlanders will start to work their way out. Webb gets the pass across to the far side for McNeil, but somebody was in just a step early, and so we'll get an offside against the Highlanders. 104 left in the penalty, 115 remaining here in period number one. Gillis, the captain, will take this draw against Dawson McCauley. Highlanders get possession off of the draw. Nolan McNeil with it now. He'll play it back across to, I believe that's Rovers. Yes, it is Rovers. And Rovers gets the puck ahead. Down the ice it goes. No icing. We're into the final minute of the first period. 50 seconds left in the penalty, and now it is launched down the ice by the Thunder captain, Jacob McClellan. Back to get it is Rovers. Rovers out from behind his net. He'll play it ahead. Working forward with it now, Nolan McNeil. He gets it forward to his captain, Gillis, who will send it down behind the net. Webb will get to it in the near corner. Gives to Cameron. Cameron trying to get away from Paris. Paris able to tie him up with 18 seconds left in the penalty. Gillis. Now he's getting tied up. Gillis able to kick the puck forward. Ends up right in the feet of Countway, but of Paris. And then Cameron had it for a moment, but able to find it is McClellan, and McClellan will launch it down the ice. That will bring the penalty to an end. We're down to the last 10 seconds of the period. So the Highlanders still without a power play goal this season. And the Thunder are now 1-for-1 on the penalty kill as the horn sounds to bring the first period to an end. And we get a little bit of a conversation between Ryan McDonald and Rossi McPhee right there at the end of the period. But cooler heads will quickly prevail, and both teams will head off to their benches or their dressing rooms after the opening 20 minutes. Shots on goal end up favoring the Highlanders in that period, 15-10. But the two more important numbers than the shots on goal right now are 27, which is the number on the back of Aiden Bowie, who scored the goal for the Highlanders, and 9, the number on the back of Ethan Daly, who scored the goal for the Fundy Thunder. And when you break all that down, it's a 1-1 tie after the opening 20 minutes. We're going to take a break. We'll come back, get you ready for the start of the second period in just a few minutes. You are watching Nova Scotia Under 16 AAA Hockey League action here on Petter Sports and streaming through Atlantic Hockey Online, a division of AO Live.
Something was up, I just didn't know how to fix it.
Thank you for bringing that to my attention. And
I knew I could fight with it till the end of the period.
Yeah.
But that's why you didn't see any of in that period.
Yeah, no, that's...
Yeah. Can't center zoom and know where I'm doing.
Yeah, no, that's cool. And to be honest, I wasn't even looking, so I
didn't know if you looked or not.
Yeah. No, I get
All right, welcome back as we get ready for the start of the second period here. A 1-1 tie between the Highlanders and the Thunder after the opening 20 minutes. A very entertaining first period of hockey. We had some good hitting. We had some nice offensive plays. We had all kinds of great things going on in this game. We saw a few very nice saves by both Thorne and Broussard. What do we have in store for the second period? Well, we have to just wait and find out. As a pass ahead to Webb. Webb fanned on his first attempt to get the puck down the ice. Second attempt does get it down. Thorne will settle it there for his defenseman, Vandenberg. Vandenberg apparently I was told by my cameraman, Ashton, a two-sport athlete. Does some racing in the summer as well as playing hockey in the winter. Here's a pass ahead to Mathis George. George will bring the puck in, has it knocked off his stick by Rovers. Following up on the play is McClellan. The captain with the shot, save, rebound. George with a chance, but a second save made as well there by Tucker Broussard. As the Thunder with the first early pressure here in this second period. Now the Highlanders work their way out. Gillis has the puck knocked off his stick. Rovers following up will dump it down into the Thunder zone. Ryan McDonald back to get it. For Fundy, working his way ahead, gets the pass forward to George. And George dumps it down. And it goes all the way around to the far side, going after it there. Carson McDonald, he'll send it back below the goal line. And it will be number 17, Aiden McDonald, on the puck there. It comes to the line. There's a shot from Carson McDonald, and Tucker Broussard makes the save and hangs on for a faceoff. 1:26 gone here in the second period. And again, I reference the numbers for the Aiden McDonalds, because one is number 11, the other is number 17. They're both Aiden McDonald, and they are both listed on the in the roster as forwards, and they both are forwards. So I can't even say forward Aiden McDonald or defenseman Aiden McDonald. So I'm not... I know sometimes you watch play-by-play guys, and it makes it look like they don't know the teams if they're saying, and 17 has the puck. Well, I'm doing that to try and differentiate the two guys who have the exact same name. As Aiden McDonald, number 17, kicked at the puck. It ended up going off of a Fundy player and then back towards him. And then Landry able to get it out and down the ice. Countway back to get it. Uses the wall to work it up for Dugan. Dugan can't get it under control. Now Countway will pick it back up again. He'll work to the far side. Plays it back over to the near wall. Gage Stewart will pick it up. Gets it ahead to Wood. Wood not able to work his way around his man. It comes to the line. Stewart will fire it into the far corner. It comes up the wall. Alexander Broussard will pick it up there. Take it back below his own goal line. Just able to get away from Carson McDonald, but not able to get away from Dugan. But the Highlanders get it back. They end up coughing it up now to Wood. Wood can't hold it in the zone as 17 Aiden McDonald able to get it out. Let me just double check one other thing here. Do-do-do-do-do. As, okay. Well, see, now that doesn't even help me. Because I look on the roster, and they are on the roster that has where their hometowns are, they are both showing as number 11. So I don't know which one is actually number 11 and which one is 17. So anybody who can tell me which one's from Antigonish and which one's from Little Judick, then I will use Antigonish Aiden McDonald or Little Judick and Aiden McDonald to differentiate them. Meanwhile, here's Nolan McNeil with the puck. He has it roll off his stick. Countway will get it up the other way as we near 3.5 minutes gone in the second period. O'Neill avoids one hit but couldn't avoid the second one, coughed the puck up. Now trying to get it back in deep was Hunt, but it goes off a skate. Just holding it in at the line there is Dwyron. Now it'll come into the near side corner. Harrison there, he takes a bump from one of the Highlander players. I couldn't quite see the number clearly. Now I see that it was Austin Landry. Puck comes to the line. There's a shot, save made by Tucker Broussard. Puck comes to the front of the net. It ends up going right through the feet of Harrison. I don't think he was expecting the puck to get to him. Now it gets to the line, held in at the point by Hunt. He plays it off the end boards. It'll come all the way up. Alexander Broussard able to poke it out to center. Paris picks up there. He'll dump it back in. Thunder have to touch up. Now they all do. And out come the Highlanders. And it's Alexander Broussard. He dumps it right in onto Thorne. Thorne settles it there. And back to pick up is Hunt. Hunt trying to work free from the pressure as Rossi McPhee was forechecking. But the Thunder are able to work their way out through the pressure. William Singer gets the shot on goal. And the save made by Tucker Broussard. And he'll hang on for a faceoff with 4:43 gone in the period. As I got that. Thank you to Jocelyn McIsaac Matheson for liking the Petter Sports and Streaming page, and Darlene Sutherland Gilby for liking my page as well. Really much appreciated there. As the puck is worked down the ice, Ryan McDonald will get to it for the Thunder. Plays it into the corner. The first one to touch it was a Highlander, but the Thunder do get it back. Now here's Singer. His pass across. Vandenberg had to stretch to try and get on that, but couldn't quite get it under control. Now Vandenberg has it back again. He'll play it ahead to McCauley. Comes up to Singer. Singer brings it in across the line. Fires a shot. That ends up going wide. Puck comes up the boards. Ryan McDonald stepping in his shot. And another save made by Tucker Broussard. Now Vandenberg steps up from his position at the point. And again, coming in and stepping up is Ryan McDonald, as both Thunder defensemen showing a willingness to step up into the play. Now from his spot back at the point, Vandenberg sends a shot in. That goes wide. Puck will be picked up, and now Oliver takes it out from behind his own net. Plays it to the line, not out. It was held in momentarily by Singer. Now it does come out, and Webb will pick up. He'll come in. Webb gets around. McDonald gets the shot away, and Thorne makes the save. Might have made the save right off of his forehead. Couldn't tell from here for sure. As Ryan McDonald nearly puts the puck right on target onto his own net, but it was cleared away by Vandenberg. Now it's down into the corner. Vandenberg gets to it there. He'll play it ahead for McClellan. McClellan up to Singer. Singer has Daly coming up with him. Singer in across the line, still has Daly. Singer tries to go through the defense, but Rover is able to knock the puck away from him. Now McClellan can't quite get his stick on it. Countway able to use the boards to knock it back to McClellan. Where's the puck gone? It ends up... Did the puck end up in McClellan? No. There it is. Now it's on the ice. I don't know where that puck actually went to. But either way, with 13:17 left to go in the period, we'll get a face-off inside the Highlander zone. Landry ends up losing his footing as he was going across to try and get that puck. Held in at the line by McClellan. There's a deflection! And what a deflection by Ethan Daly! And Daly will get his second goal of the game.
Oh, the clock.
The clock never got stopped when the goal was scored. About 25 seconds clicked off. So the time of the goal is shown as 6:58, so it was actually 26 seconds that ticked off between the time the goal was scored and the time the puck was dropped. I think in the grand scheme of things, neither bench actually noticed that the clock never stopped, so I suppose no harm, no foul. And the game just goes on. And to be fair to those guys down in the booth, it's not an easy job down there. And we're going to get another penalty against the Thunder. It's going to go against Owen Wood. And I only bring it up because as somebody who is on the autism spectrum, I'm a stickler for details. So when I notice a detail that ends up becoming incorrect, I have a hard time dismissing it without talking about it first. And so I do apologize, but that's just the way it I go. Highlanders on the power play. Interference. The call. So the penalty goes to Owen Wood for interference at 8:18. The goal scoring, by the way, Ethan Daly, his second of the game, second of the season, obviously, since this is their home or their season opener. Jacob McClellan gets his second assist. Mathis George gets the second assist for his first point of the year. And the time of that goal listed as 6:58. And that does make it 2-1 in favor of the Thunder. And there we go, 2-1 in favor of the Thunder. Here's Alex Broussard working his way in. With still 58 seconds left of power play time for the Highlanders to work. That's number 17, Aiden McDonald, playing the puck across to the far side for Rovers. Rovers tries to get a shot away. He does get the shot away, but Carson McDonald blocks it and then takes the puck over to the wall, ends up falling on the puck, and so we'll get a stoppage in play with 42 seconds left in the penalty and 10:24 left to go here in the second period. Thunder now out in front 2-1. Or should I say Daly out in front of Bowie 2-1 at this point in the game. And the puck cleared down the length of the ice by Damon O'Neill. It ends up going right on target on Tucker Broussard, who steers it over to the wall. Big hit delivered on Rovers by Dwyron. And then Nolan McNeil comes in and delivers a hit on Dwyron in response to that. And Dwyron still on the puck. Now he takes another hit, and that's going to lead to a penalty against the Highlanders. And that all started with a good hard hit delivered by Dwyron. And we're going to get a cross-checking penalty against Nolan McNeil. So we'll play 13 seconds of 4-on-4. And then the Thunder, who are 1-for-1 with the power play, will get their second man advantage of the night. Highlanders have too many guys out there for the draw, so now we'll get Webb sent over to the bench. That'll mean there's enough players and the right amount of players to get the game going again. Here's O'Neill with the puck, taking it behind the net. Gets it towards the front. Not able to get a shot away was Dwyron. Now we are into the Fundy Thunder power play. There's a shot from the line by Vandenberg, blocked by Broussard. Rovers plays it around the boards, held in at the line by Vandenberg. He'll play it to the near side. Ryan McDonald gets it down to Dwyron. Dwyron, his shot misses the net. What a quick hustle there by Vandenberg to keep that puck onside. Great effort by the Thunder defenseman. Now there's a shot from a sharp angle by Ryan McDonald. It goes off the side of the net. McDonald gets his own rebound back. Takes it right behind the net. Takes a look around. Now gives the puck to, is that Vandenberg down in the corner? I believe it was, and he ended up coughing up the puck, and now Gillis will come out with it. No, it wasn't Vandenberg. Excuse me, it was Wood. Now here's Vandenberg with a nice play against Gillis to create the turnover. Long lead pass connects with Singer. Here comes Singer coming in. But a good recovery by McNeil. That being Cole McNeil. Now Landry, or sorry, Broussard gets run over. I didn't see which player ended up hitting him. I think it might have been Singer. And I think Singer's going to get a penalty for it. So the Thunder, who were on the power play at least briefly, will go back to 4-on-4 again. This time the 4-on-4 will last for 52 seconds. And then we'll get the third power play of the night for the Highlanders, who are still looking for their first power play goal of the season. Third game in for them. So as we play 4-on-4, there's a lead pass intended for McCauley. McCauley does not get a piece of that puck, so it's going to be an icing call against the Thunder. Still 40 seconds left to go in the 4-on-4. 1:48 left in Singer's penalty, and 8:35 remaining here in period number two. Our next broadcast overall on Petter Sports and streaming through Atlantic Hockey Online, a part of AO Live, is going to be tomorrow night from the Pictou County Wellness Center. We'll have Nova Scotia Under-18 Major Hockey League action as the week's majors play a home game. That dump-in ends up hitting Landry right in the midsection, or maybe a little below the midsection, hard to tell. But Landry in a little discomfort as he makes his way to the bench. Now here's Alexander Broussard working the puck up the ice. He gets taken down, and the puck is cleared down the ice. Still playing 4-on-4. Cameron has to hustle to get back to the puck. He does, takes a bump there from McCauley. Rovers back to get the puck. He'll give it back to Cameron again, and now we're back on to a Highlander power play, but icing was at first indicated, then gets waved off. Now falling as he tried to play the puck was Wood. He turns it over to Cameron. Cameron gets the shot away, the save made. And the rebound was there, but Gillis not able to get a stick on it. It's played around to the near side now for Webb. 40 seconds left in this man advantage. Webb at the wall, trying to go far side with it. He does get it across. Countway did get a piece of that pass. He ended up deflecting the pass onto the pad of Thorne, and then it ended up on the stick of Cameron. Now we got another player down as Dwyron was forechecking hard, ended up taking himself down. Has a bit of a smile as he gets back to his feet. 21 seconds left in the Thunder penalty. Puck is dumped into the Cabot zone. Back to get it is Rovers. He'll play it to Nolan McNeil. Right back to Rovers again. Across for Webb. Webb trying to get away from the forecheck of Daly. Daly with two goals already tonight and creating havoc here on the penalty kill. Now a long cross ice pass does connect with Cameron. We're back to 5-on-5. There's a shot. Thorne makes the save. Rebound cleared away from the front by Paris. Now it'll come out to center ice. Connors will pick up there and play it down. Was close enough to Hunt that Hunt could have played it, says the lines person, so we don't have an icing. Now it's cleared to the line. Nolan McNeil able to hold it in. Works it down the wall. Tried to get it to Webb, but Webb knocked it down with his glove, and the next player to touch it was Gillis. And so that means that is a hand pass against the Highlanders with 6:19 remaining here in the second period. Shots on goal now sitting at 22-22. So in this period, it's 12-7 for Fundy in the shot department. Cole McNeil dumps it in. It goes off the arm of Vandenberg, and Vandenberg then fans on his first attempt to move the puck. It'll be picked up by number 17, Aiden McDonald. following up and supporting him is Kavanaugh. He ends up coming back to the line. There's a shot from the point by Connors. That gets blocked, and McPhee able to work it back down off the end boards. Vandenberg will pick it up. He'll play it to the far corner, and Carson McDonald gets it out down the ice. And a race for the puck, but nobody's able to get to it before it crosses the goal line. Despite the best effort of Henry Dugan, he was tied up a little bit there by Cole McNeil, and maybe McNeil a little bit lucky that he didn't get called on an interference there as he tied up his man on that icing. 5:47 left to go here in the second period. King in to take the draw against Wood. King able to win it for the Highlanders. Nolan McNeil tries to play it down the boards. It ends up hitting the linesperson. Now Broussard with it. And that's going to be another hand pass as Broussard tried to glove it down to himself but ended up gloving it down to Marlo King. And so that'll be a hand pass. And so the faceoff will move out to center ice. 5:34 remaining here in the second period. Puck will come back to Countway. Plays it off the boards up to Carson McDonald. McDonald being tied up, so he plays it back to Countway again. Ahead to Dugan, who deflects it forward, and Nolan McNeil will pick up in his own zone. McNeil plays it over for Oliver, but Oliver has it stolen from him. Trying to get it back to the line was Dugan, but Countway was coming closer to the middle of the ice, and so the Thunder have to go back out. Now Broussard creates the turnover, brings it into the Fundy zone, plays it to number 11, Aiden McDonald, who sends it down into the corner. Now it's back out to center ice, and the same number 11, Aiden McDonald, will take it all the way back into his own zone, trying to create some space, gets the puck ahead to Broussard. Broussard's cross-ice pass is broken up by Carson McDonald, who takes a bump from Aiden McDonald. I won't mention the number again. Actually, now Aiden McDonald going off on a change. So, and we're going to get a too many players on the ice penalty against the Thunder. And so the bench minor leads to the fourth power play situation of the night for the Highlanders. And while the Highlanders still have not scored with a power play this season, you can't give any team too many opportunities before it will come back to bite you. This too many players penalty will be served by Mathis George. And so Cabot on their fourth power play of the night. Connors. Or Cameron, rather, sends the puck back to the line. That is on net. Rovers able to just keep the puck away from Daly enough, as Daly did bring it out of the zone but couldn't get by Rovers. Now Rovers will take it out from behind his own net. 30 seconds gone on the man advantage. Played ahead to Webb. Webb trying to get away from Daly. Stops so that he gets a little bit of space. Now plays it down the wall to Cameron. Cameron being watched there by Paris. Paris able to tie him up in the wall. Cameron able to get away from Paris and away from the wall. Plays it back to the line for Rovers. Rovers with a shot. Kick save made by Thorne. Stepping up from the line is Nolan McNeil. He'll play it around to the far side as he gets his stick up into the face of his man Hunt. As the Thunder are able to get the puck and clear it down the length of the ice. 57 seconds left to go in the Highlander power play. Long lead pass, but just getting his stick on it is Vandenberg. And that will result in an offside against Cameron. As if Vandenberg doesn't deflect that puck, Cameron takes that pass and he's in all alone. A big defensive play there by Daniel Vandenberg. And Vandenberg has been absolutely a horse out there on the defensive side of the puck for the Fundy Thunder here tonight. And he has the puck again, tries to clear it down the ice on the penalty kill, but Broussard with a nice play to knock that one down. Alexander Broussard comes to the near side, tries to play it back to Oliver, nearly didn't get enough on it, but Oliver couldn't do much with it as The Thunder are able to get down the ice. Then Dwyron ends up losing an edge. And then Connors ends up losing an edge. And now 17, Aiden McDonald coming down the ice as there's a delayed penalty coming up against the Thunder. So it's going to be 5-on-3 here if the Thunder touch the puck in the next 13 seconds. Here's Oliver with it. His shot. That's blocked, but no control. So play goes on. And here's Broussard back to the line for Nolan McNeil. 6-on-4 right now to the front of the net. Aiden McDonald, with the shot. And the save made. And they're going to take Aiden McDonald as well. Okay. He took a shot after the whistle had blown, apparently. So head contact on the one side, slashing was the other one. Okay. Slash on the goalie. Okay, there we go. So it'll be a two-minute penalty up on the board, because it was a four-minute double minor. So somebody's going to have to come and serve the extra two for Hayden Dwyron. All of this coming with 2:29 left to go in the second period. So 1 second of 5-on-3. And Aiden McDonald's penalty does not go up on the clock, as it is coincidental with two of the 4 minutes. And so now it's, after that 1 second, it is back to a 5-on-4 again. It was 5-on-3 again, just for that 1 second. Here's Webb with the puck. He'll work his way ahead. Throws it to the front of the net. What a save off the shot by Gillis. Webb with a beautiful pass across to the back door. But Jake Thorne says, nobody's getting a puck by me on that side. Not tonight. What a save by the Thunder goaltender. Here's Rovers now. He'll take a look. Get the puck ahead to Webb. Webb settles it down right along the center ice line. Plays it back to Nolan McNeil. Ahead for Gillis. Gillis deflects it into the zone, but it's knocked down by Singer. Now it ends up back with Gillis. This time he comes across. He's got Webb with him, but the puck is turned over as Countway steps up. 52 seconds left in the penalty. 1:20 left to go in the period. Now Nolan McNeil steps up and delivers a nice hit on Waylon Countway. Long lead pass. And here's Cameron. His shot just up over the crossbar. Pass ahead. Broken up. Connors brings it in. Didn't realize that he had a man in offside. So we'll get a stoppage. 28 seconds left in the penalty. 57.3 seconds left to go here in the second period. Face-off will be on the right-wing side from the Highlanders' perspective. So McPhee will come in and take the draw against McClellan. Puck cleared down the ice, back to get it is Oliver. 18 seconds left in the penalty. Here with it now is Connors. He gets it ahead to Alexander Broussard. Broussard had it end up in his feet, kicked the puck ahead. Now 11, Aiden McDonald plays it towards the corner. Comes up the wall to Broussard. Penalty is expired. We're back to 5-on-5. 22 seconds left in the period. There's a shot, save, rebound, and a second chance save made by Jake Thorne, and he'll hang on for another faceoff. 19.4 seconds left to go. here in period number two. Face off to the right of Jake Thorne. 17, Aiden McDonald taking the draw against Connors. There's a shot, they score! Broussard able to find the tiniest of space over the shoulder of Jake Thorne. And with 14 seconds left in the second period, we are tied again. It's now 2-2. I want to say it was Rossi McPhee who took that shot. We'll wait for the official word. And, or sorry, it was Broussard. I should have known that because I actually said it as Broussard took the shot. So for Aiden Broussard, or sorry, Alexander Broussard, that's his first goal, second point of this game. First goal and second point of this season as well. And that will do it for period number two. Number 17, Aiden McDonald, gets the only assist on the goal. So Broussard's first goal, second point, assisted by Aiden McDonald. Number 17, Aiden McDonald, to differentiate, at 19:46 of the second period to put us back tied. We were tied after one, at one. We're tied after two, at two. Shots on goal in the second period end up 14-12 in favor of the Highlanders. The two-period total favors Cabot 29-22. We'll take a break. We'll come back, get you ready for the third period in just a few minutes. You are watching Nova Scotia Under 16 AAA Hockey League action here on Petter Sports and streaming through Atlantic Hockey Online, a division of AO Live. All right, welcome back as we get ready for the start of the third period here. 2-2 the score between the Fundy Thunder and the Cabot Highlanders. The opening game of the season for the Thunder. The first road game of the season for the Cabot Highlanders as the regular season started last season. And I was just talking to the man in charge with the Fundy Thunder, and he just let me know that I was not crazy about this, at least. My sanity is sometimes in question, but about this I was not. Tonight's game was originally scheduled to be against the Basin Armada. So all of the stuff that I had done, all the stuff that I had posted was correct. The schedule got changed very, very recently. Like within the last couple of days that it got changed to the Highlanders being the opponent for tonight. As a little bit of gamesmanship between Singer and Cameron before the puck drop. So, and if you look on the AO Live page, we do have a Fundy Thunder page on the sub page on the AO Live page. That schedule will have to be changed because the St. John team from St. John, New Brunswick had to fold just before the season got started. So there are changes constantly coming to the schedule as a result. So we will be getting those updates put onto our page to reflect what the new schedule looks like as soon as we get them all cleared away. But one thing we can tell you for sure is if the Highlanders, as here's a chance with a bad turnover right in front, and Gillis not able to take advantage as Thorne makes a save to bail out his defenseman. I'm not sure if, I think it was Ryan McDonald who coughed up that puck to the captain, Josh Gillis. But as I was about to say, we can tell you that if the Fundy Thunder are playing a home game, it will be on Petter Sports and Streaming this year. So that you can be assured of. And unless, of course, a game gets changed as a charging penalty gets called here with 1:21 and a game all of a sudden gets added to the schedule with not enough notice for us to get ready, but that rarely happens. So the charging penalty taken by Waylon Countway. So I will put on the caveat that, you know, unless it is absolutely, absolutely unavoidable, we will have every Fundy Thunder home game here on Petter Sports and Streaming this season. So if you're looking for a Thunder home game and you're looking for where to watch it, it'll be here with us. Whether they're playing here at the Rath Eastlink Community Center in Truro, whether they're playing at the Pictou County Wellness Center on the outskirts of New Glasgow and Stellarton. If it's Thunder home, it's Petter Sports. As the Highlanders are now on their sixth power play of the evening with that charging penalty taken by Countway. 1:15 left to go in the man advantage, and here comes Broussard, who scored the tying goal with 14 seconds left in the second period. And it was over the shoulder glove side of Jake Thorne. Just over the shoulder and just inside the far post on Thorne, that goal that was scored with 14 seconds left. Here there's 1:09 left to go in the penalty. And while shorthanded, Mathis George able to bring the puck out to center. He takes a hit. Following up on the play is Curtis Weatherby. He gets the puck in deep. Now Webb will pick up. He takes a bump. McNeil gets it. That being Nolan McNeil gets it back to Webb again. And Webb will carry into the Thunder zone. Drops off for Cameron. Cameron with a shot. And Thorne able to watch that one right into his glove and make the save and hang on. 41 seconds remaining here in the third period. I speak English. Did you know that? 41 seconds left to go in the penalty. 17:20 left to go here in the third period of this tie hockey game. 2-2 between the Cabot Highlanders and the Fundy Thunder. Gillis with the puck. His shot goes off a leg. It ends up right on the stick of Webb. He fires a shot. I don't know if Thorne knew where it was, but it ended up near side. Now Rovers with it at the line. He'll play it down the wall to McNeil. Nolan McNeil gets it to Gillis. That pass ends up in Gillis' skates, and that allows the Thunder to find it, and Gage Stewart will bring it out and dump it down into the Cabot zone. 11 seconds left in the power play. Here's Rovers out from behind his net. Gets the pass forward. Long lead pass now from Webb to Cameron. Cameron just gets a piece of the puck. Ryan McDonald blasts it off his own end boards. Puck goes up into the air, comes down onto the stick of Webb. Cameron all alone in front. But before Webb could actually get to the puck and make a pass to Cameron, it ends up on the side of the net. Now Cameron into the corner. He takes a bump, gets it behind the net for Gillis, but Gillis collides with Ryan McDonald. Aiden Landry holds the puck in at the line, and we get a stoppage as the net for the Thunder ended up getting dislodged with all of that traffic running around as the Cabot Highlanders continue to outshoot the Fundy Thunder. Now they're outshooting them by 10. Here, 32-22, and part of that you can account for the six power plays for the Cabot Highlanders versus just two power plays for the Fundy Thunder. Obviously, that is part of the discrepancy in shots. Damon O'Neill with the puck. He'll get it ahead to Dwyron. Dwyron gives back to O'Neill as they come in across the line, but an offside gets called as Harrison, I think, had come in across the line just a step early. 3:55 gone here, second or third period. And again, a reminder, the Thunder as of right now, and again, schedules being what they are, the Thunder are scheduled to play a home game again next Friday night here at the Rath Eastlink Community Center against the Moncton Thunderbirds. And we will have that game for you 7 o'clock next Friday from here at the Rath Eastlink Community Center. And that will be our next Fundy Thunder broadcast. Thunder are scheduled to play a game on the road tomorrow. They'll be going to take on the Bucks, the Martello Buccaneers. For the Highlanders, their next game will not be until next Saturday. Their next game is also against the Bucks, coincidentally enough, the Martello Buccaneers, and that will be a home game against the Martello Buccaneers next Saturday, a week from tomorrow, October 7th. And that's a 3 o'clock puck drop. And while I haven't had the opportunity myself to watch a Highlanders stream, I can tell you that every team in the league will be streaming home games this year. And I'm sure that they will all be doing a fantastic job. Connors plays the puck back to Rovers. Rovers gets it to the far side for McPhee, who goes it right back to Rovers again. Now up to Broussard. Broussard's pass across to the far side. Too far for McPhee. Vandenberg will use the wall to get it back in across the Highlander line. And now Rovers taking a look. He'll get the pass ahead. King trying to work his way forward. But he coughs up the puck, and now here's Singer with it. Singer gives to McCauley, who fires a shot. And the save made by Tucker Broussard. With 14:27 left to go here, third period. And the Cabot Highlanders and Fundy Thunder remain tied at 2 goals apiece. We were talking about what the playoff format might look like this season, with it now being an 11-team league. Well, it's still obviously in flux with the fact that there was a change in the number of franchises basically just before the season got just as the season got rolling. Here's the puck tied up along the end boards. McCauley Gets it over to Countway. Countway with a sharp angle shot. And Tucker Broussard makes another save and hangs on for another faceoff. Just under 6 minutes gone here in the third period. Both of these goaltenders have played very well here tonight. Tucker Broussard now 23 saves on 25 shots. While at the other end, Jake Thorne, 30 saves on 32 shots. And anytime you can say as a goaltender, you made 30 saves in a game, you're doing all right. Landry brings the puck into the Thunder zone and is able to get the better of a hit between himself and Caden Paris. Now a little bit of a miscommunication there, Paris and Countway. But they're able to get the puck down into the Cabot zone. Broussard will play it across. Picked up there by Singer. Singer steps up. Singer trying to get a pass across. Lost control, but there's a shot taken by Weatherby. And a little bit of a knuckleball there. One that Phil Niekro would have been proud of. But able to recover. Yeah, I know, I'm showing my age there. Ashton looks over at me, goes, I don't know who that is. Yeah, you young little whippersnapper. How about I use R.A. Dickey? Is that a that? Okay, there we go, yeah. See, Phil Niekro was the R.A. Dickey long before R.A. Dickey came around. As we hear the announcement again of the major sponsor for the Fundy Thunder, McKay Truck and Trailer Center. And we want to echo that here on the broadcast. Events or teams like this cannot function without corporate sponsorship. So McKay Truck and Trailer Center, who are the major sponsor of the Fundy Thunder, thank you so much for your support. Now here comes a chance for Gillis. Gillis coming in. Gillis with a move. What a save by Jake Thorne! Oh my goodness, what a save. As the captain of the Highlanders was coming in alone and Thorne able to get across and put the glove out there to stop Josh Gillis and keep this game tied. That's a save worthy of the highlight reels on the national. What a goal by Landon Webb. I don't even get to finish talking about how beautiful the previous save was. And then we get an absolute picturesque. When you talk about how to get a deflection onto the net, you could use that goal right there by Landon Webb for instructional videos on how to conduct a deflection in front of the net. That was beautiful. Rovers and Gillis get the assists on that. And for Webb, just want to confirm this here. Yes, Webb did not have a point on the previously in this season. So for Landon Webb, that is his first goal, first point of the year. Andre Rovers and Josh Gillis with the assists. And the Highlanders carry a lead now for the second time in this game. They led for a little over 10 minutes in the first period. And now they lead here in a third. There's a shot blocked by Paris. Puck ends up with Dwaron. Dwaron goes to dump it in. It goes off of Landry. Landry will get to it. Play it around to the far side for Nolan McNeil. His pass ahead knocked down by Dugan. Now around to the near side. Worked up the wall and out to center. Here comes Broussard. He's got Cameron trying to catch up with him. Vandenberg able to poke the puck down to the corner. Broussard picks it back up again, able to shield it, now plays it across. Nolan McNeil fires a shot from the point and the save made by Thorne, and he'll hang on for a faceoff. What an amazing sequence of events we had there just a few moments ago, folks. A beautiful textbook glove save on a breakaway by Jake Thorne. And then just seconds later, playing time-wise, we did have a stoppage, and so it took a few more seconds than that. It probably was a minute or so in real time, but seconds later in playing time, an incredible goal on a shot from the point, deflected beautifully by Landon Webb, and Jake Thorne had no chance on it at all, as the redirection ended up putting it right through his legs. And took this 2-2 game that it was and gave the Highlanders the 3-2 lead they now have and still hold with exactly 11 minutes left on the clock. As Wood gets waved out of the faceoff circle because Carson McDonald came into the zone or into the circle just a little too early. Shot goes wide. Ryan McDonald able to hold it in at the line. Now a shot, and that goes off the post. Owen Wood rings that one off the inside of the post. And we were that close to this game being tied up again. Owen Wood with a great shot. Fractions of an inch. And there's a chance, and they score! As Jake Thorne misplays the puck as it comes off the end boards. It goes right onto the stick of one of the Highlander players. And it looks like it was McPhee. We'll wait for confirmation of this. But Rossi McPhee led the celebration line across the bench, which is why I want to say it was Rossi McPhee who got that puck after. You hate to want to point out that a goal was scored because of a player's mistake, but part of doing the analysis is, as we get confirmation of McPhee's goal, and they give McPhee that goal unassisted, as the puck was dumped down the ice, came off the end boards, Thorne misplayed it, and it ended up right on the stick of McPhee, and Thorne was still reaching out a little bit from having misplayed the puck, hadn't got himself set square again, and so Rossi McPhee had a lot of net to work with and a goalie who was not set to try and make a save. There's a shot, a nice deflection by Singer, and Tucker Broussard able to keep himself in front of that one. So for the first time in this game, we've now got a two-goal margin. And the Thunder will have to work to try and get themselves back into it, and they only have 9 minutes and 35 seconds with which to do it. Highlanders led 1-0, scoring just a minute and 7 seconds in. They held that lead for a little over 10 minutes, and then the Thunder scored to tie it up. It stayed that way till about 7 minutes into the second period, when the Thunder took their first lead of the game to make it 2-1. They held that lead for about 13 minutes. There's a shot and they score! As the shot from the point by Vandenberg, it looked like it may have been redirected. And with 9:27 left, we're back to a one-goal game. So the two-goal margin only lasts for 57 seconds. And now the Thunder are back to within one. And Daniel Vandenberg, I do believe, will get credit for this goal. So Vandenberg does get the goal. Mathis George gets his second assist of the game. And then there's nearly a tying goal coming just seconds later. So there's a deflection off the stick of Nolan McNeil as he tried to knock the puck down but ended up knocking it towards his goaltender, Tucker Broussard, and Broussard had to be sharp on that one. I did a Junior A game last night where there were 15 goals in the first two periods. The longest stretch we had between goals at any point in the first two periods of that game last night was 4 minutes and 13 seconds. This game, in the last couple of minutes, and there's a chance and a big save coming across by Thorne. This game is developing the feel that that game last night had, the difference being the goaltenders, Thorne and Broussard, have made a couple of really nice saves, but a lot of these scoring opportunities are coming off of miscues, and both of these teams are doing a great job of turning the miscues of another team into opportunities for themselves. And we are in for a wild finish here for the last 8 minutes and 30 seconds. Here's Broussard with the puck, but that's going to be a penalty as McNeil took Carson McDonald, that being Nolan McNeil, took Carson McDonald into the boards. And it's going to be a boarding call with 8:27 left. So now the third power play of the night for the Thunder. The Thunder are 1-for-2 with the man advantage. So a chance here to tie this game up if they can score with the power play for the second time tonight. The power play goal that they scored in the first period was also a game-tying goal at the time to make it 1-1. There's a shot right on by Paris. That steered aside. Puck played back to the line. O'Neill holds it in there, plays it across the far side. Stepping up, getting the shot away is Hunt. Puck is steered to the corner. Carson McDonald backs up with it. Now gives to O'Neill. O'Neill takes it over to the far wall, gives it to Hunt. Hunt takes it down towards the corner, fires a shot. Save made by Broussard. And he'll hang on for a faceoff. 32 seconds gone in the penalty. Broussard has now made 29 saves on 32 shots tonight. And has come up with three big saves already on this penalty kill as the Thunder look to tie up this game. 7:55 to go, third period. A minute and a half left in the penalty, but a big possession off of the faceoff for the Highlanders as they're able to clear the puck down the ice. King now watching as Hunt has the puck behind the net. Hunt comes out. He gives it to Paris. Paris able to give to Hunt right back to, or to Wood, who gives back to Paris. Now there's a sharp angle shot, save, rebound, and picking up is Wood. Owen Wood makes a move, plays it back to the line for Troy Hunt. Back for Wood, that's out of his reach, but getting to the puck is Dwyeron. Dwyeron with a shot, that goes wide. Race to get to the puck, and Dwyeron able to win it from Connors, and then Dwyeron gets tripped up, so it's going to be a 5-on-3 if they let the Highlanders touch the puck. And now, as Connors does, Connors is going to go for the tripping, and this is a big 33 seconds of 5-on-3 here for the Fundy Thunder. And will we see the Thunder take their timeout to try and set something up for this 5-on-3? Doesn't look like they will. This might very well be their best scoring opportunity with exactly 7 minutes left to go in the third period. This might be the best chance that they get for the rest of this game to try and tie it up. Countway with the puck. Gives to McClellan. McClellan takes it up to the point. Now he'll skate it along the blue line. Gives to Countway near boards all the way down into the corner. Countway. 10 seconds left in the 5-on-3. Now it's across. Pass back across to Countway. Cantway fires a shot, misses the far post, comes up the wall to Vandenberg. First penalty is ended. Down into the corner for Daly. Daly sends it behind the net. George will pick up there. A minute 20 left to go in the power play. Mathis George has two assists already tonight. Now he gives the puck to McClellan. McClellan down to the near side. Cantway coming back up the wall. Now he'll turn, take it back down the boards. Gives to George. George coming to the middle of the ice. Fires a shot and puts it just over the crossbar. Picked up by Vandenberg. He works it along the goal line. Plays it back. Cantway gets the puck. Steps around one man. Fires a shot looking far post. And just getting a piece of it with his glove was Broussard. May have been going wide anyway, but Broussard did get a piece of it. 45 seconds left in the man advantage. Puck comes free. Rovers trying to clear. He can't. Broussard coughs it up. There's a chance. And it goes off the stick of George into the glass. Does not go out of play. Clearing attempt does just get out past Vandenberg. 28 seconds left in the man advantage. Launch down the ice. Back to get it, Vandenberg. 17 seconds left in the power play. He gives the puck up to Singer. Singer will play it ahead. That's going to be an offside as Dwarren couldn't quite stay in the neutral zone. So we'll have an offside call with 12 seconds left in the man advantage. 5:12 left to go here in the third period. 4-3 the score in favor of the Cabot Highlanders as they look for their first win on this young season. They come into this game 0-2, the Fundy Thunder. This is their season opener. They'll be playing again tomorrow night against the Buccaneers. Again, you can go to the Buccaneers social media to find out where they stream their games from. But every team is going to be responsible for streaming all of their home games this year for the purposes of Instat. Here's Paris with the puck. Shot, save, rebound. And the rebound ends up bouncing all the way free to Webb. Webb scored the goal that gave the Highlanders the lead 3-2 at the time. Now here's number 11, Aiden McDonald. Not to be confused with number 17, Aiden McDonald. Played it to McNeil. McNeil sends it down low. Webb gets taken off of the puck. Battle for it below the goal line. Cleared away from the side of the net by Wood. Singer can't get it under control. Now it'll be played back to Singer by Hunt. Singer blasts it in. It goes off of Oliver. And Broussard makes the save. 4 minutes left to go, third period. Just keeping the puck onside is Singer. Gets it down into the corner. Nolan McNeil will play it up the wall. It'll be held in at the line there by Stewart. No, Stewart doesn't hold it in. Now it's to Carson McDonald. McDonald will bring it into the zone. Has a man heading towards the net. Carson McDonald turns, goes to play it back to the line. Lost control of the puck, and McPhee able to get it past Stewart and out to center. Deflected back into the zone by Singer as the Thunder need a change. They get some fresh legs out there. Alexander Broussard will give it to McPhee. McPhee trying to find some space. He will get out to center. Here comes McPhee. McPhee fires a shot. Blocker save made by Thorne. Now in the far corner, inside the Fundy Thunder end, 3:12 and counting left to go here, third period. Finding the puck is Gillis. He sends it around the boards. It'll come to the near side corner. Ryan McDonald will get to it first. McDonald stops, gives it to Damon O'Neill. Here comes O'Neill. O'Neill gets it ahead to McCauley, who fires a shot. That goes wide. Gillis not able to get possession of the puck to clear it. Now he does get it and is able to play it out to center. 2:40 in counting remaining. Countway will dump it in. Puck will go around the boards. Dawson McCauley gets to it. He's also got Cantway right there with him as well. They lose control of it, and now out comes Gillis. Gillis trying to work his way around Vandenberg. But Vandenberg slows him up enough that it ends up being an offside against the Highlanders. 2:21 left to go here, third period. 4-3 the score in favor of the visiting Cabot Highlanders. .39-36 the shots on goal in favor of Cabot. Shots favor the Highlanders in this period, 14-10. The two goalies have now combined for 68 saves on 75 shots tonight. And some of those saves have been of the spectacular variety. Here's Singer with the puck. Singer steps in, gets a shot away, puts it just wide of the post as he was trying to catch Broussard going the wrong way. He had Broussard moving to his right and then shot it to Broussard's left, but just missed the net. Now here's Cameron with the puck. 1:44 to go. Cameron fires a shot. That goes wide. Puck will come up the boards. Oliver not able to knock it away from Weatherby. Weatherby, though, does end up losing it. Now it's count way back behind his own net. Tries to get around Cameron. He will. Here comes Waylon Countway. He'll dump it down and go chasing after it himself. Loses the puck to Rovers. Now a pass for Cameron. That goes through his feet. It'll be picked up by Vandenberg. 1:13 to go as we keep half an eye now on goaltender Jake Thorne. If the Thunder can get the puck deep into the Highlander zone, you can bet that Thorne will be on his way to the bench. Rovers dumps it in. Thorne knocks it down behind his own net, sets it up there for Vandenberg. Vandenberg will poke it ahead for Singer. 54 seconds and counting. Here comes Singer. Singer works his way ahead as Thorne heads to the net. Here comes Singer coming in. His shot goes off the leg of Oliver. At the side wall, Wood coming to the middle of the ice. Also getting a stick on it there is Dwarin. Now Wood with it. Dwarin tries to go short side with the puck. Broussard able to make the save. And then we get some more pushing and shoving after the whistle. 32.0 seconds on the clock. And it'll be an offensive zone faceoff for the Fundy Thunder as they try to tie up this game. A game that they led for about 13 minutes of playing time. And the Thunder are going to take their timeout now to draw something up to see what they can do with these final 32 seconds of the third period to look for that equalizer. At the Cabot bench, you know they're going over defensive assignments. Who's covering where? Who's got what player? For the Thunder, you got to think about, okay, if we get offensive possession, what are we doing? How are we setting up a shot? But at the same time, if we don't get possession, who's got to do what to make sure the puck is not able to clear the zone? Lots of things that have to be talked about in a timeout of this magnitude. Here we go. Ethan Daly, who has two of the three goals tonight, takes the draw and wins it. Puck comes back to the line. Now across. There's a shot. It ends up being blocked by Rovers. Now in front of the net. There's a chance. What a save by Broussard. Puck is there. And now it's covered up and hung on by Broussard. 19.9 seconds left. What a chance for the Thunder there. Broussard comes up with a couple of huge saves. But he's going to have to possibly make at least one more if the Thunder can win another offensive zone faceoff. Daly will step aside for Wood to take the draw. Alexander Broussard in to take the faceoff for the Highlanders. Wood wins it back to Countway. Countway can't get a shot through. Daly going after the puck in the corner, trying to tie it up there and kill the rest of the clock as McNeil. 12 seconds and counting. Now trying to tie it up is Webb as the clock counts down. And Webb will do enough to finish off this game. And the Cabot Highlanders get a big victory in their first road game of the 2023-24 season. It wasn't easy, but they come away with the 4-3 win over the Fundy Thunder here this evening. Final shots on goal favor the Thunder, 41-39. They end up in that third period out shooting Cabot 19-10. But it is not enough as the Highlanders get the victory. The game-winning goal going to Rossi McPhee. Thunder drop to 0-1. Highlanders go to 1-2 on this young Nova Scotia under 16 AAA Hockey League season. Thunder will be back in action tomorrow night when they take on the Martello Buccaneers. Highlanders, their next game will also be against the Buccaneers next Saturday night. Our next broadcast will also be next weekend. It'll be Friday night when the Thunder have a home game, and we will double check and confirm who that game is against in the coming days. Until then, or until tomorrow, if you join us for the week's majors game tomorrow night from the Pictou County Wellness Center, this is Michael Petter on behalf of my awesome cameraman, Ashton Reiki, saying may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. Final score one last time. The Cabot Highlanders with a thrilling 4-3 victory over the Fundy Thunder. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy the rest of your Friday night.